Navratri.
Happy Navratri, everybody. Hey, welcome back to our Stupid Reactions, idiots. I'm Corbin.
I'm Rick.
And you can follow us on Instagram and Twitter for more juicy content.
It's so juicy.
And thank you also to Patreon and follow us on official Twitter account. And the celebration started yesterday.
It's true.
But the it's not Durga Puja. Durga Puja is specific to Calcutta. But they're taking place at the same time. This is, I forget which part of India this is from, but this is their celebration of it.
Yes, which I actually think they're linked because Durga Puja officially begins October 4th.
Yeah.
But there's a thing that starts the
They're kind of linked, but they're not the same.
No, they're not the same.
I was told
but it's the beginning of the...
Like, I was told specifically that these two are not the same thing.
No, they're not.
So
correct.
Durga Puja and that one. So this one, what we're reacting to is... say it for me again, so I don't mispronounce it.
Navratri.
Navratri.
Yes.
And so we're going to do a little video on this.
Cool.
And this was sent to us by Stupid Babies. So this is not something I just picked out of random.
Good.
Here we go.
Yeah.
I think the description should give us a little...
Yeah, because that didn't teach us a thing about the festival.
It was pretty, but obviously it didn't... We still don't really know what's going on.
I was thinking about this happens at the same time as the beginning of what's going on in Calcutta, which is Malalia starts the beginning of the festival season leading up to Durga Puja, which this year starts October 4th for all of you Bengali brothers and sisters. And that's what I was thinking about that when we were looking at the name and got confused between the two. So forgive me.
They're done the exact same time.
At the same time.
They're different cities.
Correct. Totally different. Yeah. Totally different cities and totally different festivals.
Yeah.
Related to what's going on, because in Calcutta it's for the mother goddess, which is depicted actually Kahani that has done the end of Kahani. Uh-huh. She's the mother goddess with the eight arms is being walked down the streets, and that's what's coming up.
So
there, this is a long description, everybody. You better grab a fresh cup of chai. Garba is a form of dance, which originated in the state of Gujarat in India. The name is derived from the Sanskrit term garba, womb. Many traditional garbas are performed around a central image or statue of the goddess Durga, also called Amba, or a clay lantern with a light inside called a garbadeep, womb lamp. Traditionally, it's performed during the 9-day Hindu festival Navarati, Nava, nine, Ratri, meaning nights.
Mm.
The dancers honor Amba, the feminine form of divinity. The traditional clothing for men is the kiriyu, while the traditional clothing for women,
beautiful,
is the chaniya choli. Garba is performed in a circle as a symbol of the Hindu view of time.
Cool.
The rings of dancers revolve in circles as time in Hinduism is cyclical. As the cycle of time revolves from birth to life to death and again to rebirth, the only thing that is constant is the goddess. That one unmoving symbol in the midst of all of this, unending and infinite movement. The dance symbolizes that goddess is the only thing that remains unchanging in a constantly changing universe.
Gotcha.
Got it.
Cool.
Yeah.
That is. So, yeah, that makes a lot more sense. Probably should have read that before. But, you know,
yeah, that's
it's
okay.
All our stupid reactions.
It is our stupid reactions. And we obviously we don't know what we're seeing until we see it.
Yeah.
So.
But it was, I mean, it was really pretty. Obviously, it just, it didn't give us, like.
Prep. What they're doing and why.
Yeah.
Right.
That did, the description.
Yes.
But obviously some other ones that we've shown, like, kind of explain almost in the video.
Yeah, I learned more about the United Way than I did actually at the festival in the video. I learned that they're involved and they can lay things.
If this is not a great video to explain the festival, I'm sorry. I didn't pick it. I'm
so stupid babies.
But it was really pretty, no doubt.
And it looked fun. How beautiful it is.
From what I hear on Twitter is that people say for 9 days they just dance.
Dang.
Constantly.
Like nonstop, like a dance-a-thon?
Yeah,
something like we've got those, you know, dance-a-thons. You could see it, especially back in the 1950s and 60s, was like this big deal. And Israeli dancing.
Mm-hmm.
Ashley and Harrell have done that. It's a big deal to dance all freaking night. Like, you don't sleep, you just dance.
Dancing's a lot bigger in a lot of other cultures. Like, in terms of, like, community.
Hardcore dancing.
Community
coming together and doing dancing. We have nothing here in the United States other than Friday nights at a club.
Or literal, like, festivals. Like,
or weddings.
Yeah.
Weddings would be really the only cultural thing where we have collective dancing as a community.
Yeah.
That I can think of.
And then, like, those big old festivals, like, what are they called? Running Man or Burning Man and all those kind of things.
Yeah.
Those kind of stuff.
Right.
But those aren't, those are, like, specific for, like, music people. So
I gotta say, we really don't have a lot of culture and art involved in our holidays.
Yeah.
We really don't. I mean, we got fireworks on the 4th of July, which are always fun and beautiful.
Well, it's the thing. A lot of other cultures, they have a lot of, like, a lot of one type of either religion or, obviously, it's not India, so they have 1,000 religions.
Right.
But America, since it's such a melting pot, is not one that really dominates.
True. The most dominant one, obviously, is Christmas, but that one, for me, is the most favorite in terms of its art expression, because that one has so many songs and music that is done, and there's so many things done expressively through light.
Yeah.
It's a really, and that's the largest one here, which you guys all know about that. But
Halloween, I agree. But
Halloween's huge. But again, there's no dancing involved.
It's also not really a season.
No.
People will celebrate Christmas literally from Thanksgiving sometimes before on.
All the way up to New Year's Day.
Halloween celebrated basically one day. But yeah. That's happy. How do you say it again?
I hope I'm not butchering it. I think it's Navaratri.
Happy Navaratri. I'll look up to see if there's any festivals going on here in LA. Maybe we'll...
I would love to. I would love to find out if there was that. And particularly, yeah, if there was coming up, if we could find a Bengali community that's celebrating Durga Puja and doing it. I mean, they're not going to do it the way they do in Calcutta. I'd be astonished if they came even close to...
No, they won't.
No, they would have to have pandals built and all this other stuff. You bet I didn't know about that, did you? I know what a pandal is, you Bengalis.
Cool.